Everyone, Joe here from Plum Crazy Restorations. We are having a look at the 1968 Plymouth Roadrunner. This is the Hemi car. And we've got it media blasted and in epoxy. So we're just gonna run through the car and show you some of the issues on the metal that we found. We're just gonna start by removing all the factory lead. We'll take the lead out and assess for any additional rust or damage underneath that and replace it with a modern product. Okay, gone beyond there. Just try to show everything here. We've got some rust at the deck filler seam right here to the quarter panel. This is rusted and bubbled. We're probably looking at both layers to repair that. There's also some on this side here. It's not as bad as the passenger side, but you can see it's bubbled in between the metal and separated. Inside the trunk, there's some pitting in the metal, but overall it's really solid. We just got a hole here, a factory spot weld that is burnt through, so we'll weld that up. And then we'll deal with all the other issues in the high build and bodywork stages. It's really solid trunk in this car. Tail panel, not seeing any rust or concerns in the back. I'll just step onto the left quarter panel here. Okay, there are some dents and dings throughout the panel. We've got this lip that's rolled. We're gonna bring that back down the factory. In front of the wheel well here, you can see there's quite a bit of rust, and the whole bottom of the rocker here, or bottom of the quarter panel where it wraps around the rocker, is pretty bad. So we're gonna remove this from the body line down, and that'll all be replaced. Also, once it comes out, we'll be able to assess what's going on in behind there. I'm pretty sure we're gonna need to do something on the backside. We're just not sure how bad it is yet. Behind the wheel well, it looks pretty solid from the outside, but when you get into the inside of the quarter panel, there's rust behind this metal. So we're gonna have to go in and do something with that. Otherwise, eventually it will come through the outside and come back to haunt down the road. Passenger side quarter panel, pretty much the exact same thing. We got the same issue in the back here. On the inside, there's rust and crumbling. It's actually separating from the inside. It is rusted through a bit in the back here. There's quite a few pinholes. So again, same thing. Wheel lip and front of the quarter panel here. This looks pretty solid on this side. There is some damage in the front here at the joint. So once the lead comes out, we'll get this cut open and get that dealt with. Just looking at the interior floors here, there is some area of rust here on the back floor and a little bit on the driver's side. Most of the interior floors are in really good shape. There's some damage around the gas pedal area where somebody's either bottomed out or maybe put a jack in the wrong spot at one point. Having a look at the back side here, it looks like something blew up on the rear end at one point. Came up through the floor, did a lot of damage here. This is all broken loose. The metal's cracked from top to bottom here. The rear seat bracing has been screwed back into place. It's not even welded in at the bottom anymore. So we're going to have to deal with all this and clean that all up, fix it. The rocker panels at this time look really good, not seeing any rust on them. The cowl also looks really good. Engine bay, not seeing any signs of rust here. It's a very clean car. There are some holes on the inner fenders that we want to get welded up. They're just not factory, so we want to weld those up and have the option to put this thing back to factory appearance in the engine bay when it's reassembled. Okay, as far as the panels go, everything's looking real clean. There is very minor damage on the fenders. Let's see, we've got a bit of a rust hole here. I'm just gonna fix that. This is the driver's fender. The passenger side looks really good. Both of the doors are really clean. The only downside is somebody had cut these large holes for speakers. So we're gonna rebuild this metal and again, put it back to like it never happened. Trunk lid and hood, not seeing any rust on those pieces. Everything else, like I said, looks really good on the car. So again, a few areas of rust and damage on the car and a few areas that we just still cannot see yet. So we gotta get them opened up and see what we're dealing with on the backside. Okay, we'll keep everybody up to date as progress moves along with this thing. We'll try to keep posting videos to show you how the restoration goes. And I hope these videos help anyone doing this kind of work at home.